Hey, it's Simon from supersimple.dev. Today's video is about a really important topic if you want to get a job as a web developer. So we're going to talk about what are JavaScript frameworks and which one should you learn. So pretty much every web developer uses a framework in addition to JavaScript to build web applications. And here's my detailed explanation of what a framework is. So the first thing you'll need to know is the basics of JavaScript. Now, if you don't know JavaScript yet, I have an in-depth tutorial on JavaScript, and the link to that is in the description. Now, I assume that you know JavaScript at this point. So a JavaScript framework helps you render stuff. It's a rendering system. Rendering means displaying something on a web page. It's the most common thing you do in web development. So for example, if I want to render a button on my web page, I can use this code. And this is just HTML, we don't even need JavaScript yet. Now let's say that I have a list, and I want to render this list on my web page. Well, we'll use JavaScript here to loop through this list, and for each item, we're going to create an HTML element, and then add that element to the page. So that's rendering using JavaScript. So a very common task in web development is we're going to take some complex data and we're going to use JavaScript to render that data on the web page. For example, let's say that we have a list of comments on a YouTube video, and we want to render it to look like this. In the beginning, there were no frameworks, so developers just used plain JavaScript to render data. So this is the code to render the comments using plain JavaScript, and this is the code using a framework. So as you can see, this code is way easier to read and write. You can even see the structure of the HTML that you're rendering. So if you use a JavaScript framework, you can write your code like this, and then the framework basically converts it into this JavaScript for you, and that JavaScript is going to render it on the page. So that's why web developers use frameworks. It makes our code so much more simple. Now let's go through a demo of a real framework, and this is how to use a framework. So first we have to go to the framework's website, and every framework has their own website. So if you don't know what that is, we're going to search it in Google. So we can search Backbone.js. Now once we're on the website, we're going to find a copy of the framework's code. So a framework is just a bunch of JavaScript code that someone else wrote. It's no different than the code that you write yourself. So we're going to copy all of this code and run it in our web page. So an easy way to do this is just to copy this URL, and then in our web page, we can add a script tag. And we're going to give the script tag an SRC attribute. So this SRC attribute stands for the source attribute. It will grab a copy of the code found in this URL, which is all of the framework's code, and it's going to run this code. So we're going to run the framework's code at the top of our website. And that's it. Now you can start writing your web pages like this, and the framework will convert it into JavaScript and render things for you. Of course, you have to follow the instructions for how to use the framework. So we would have to go back to the website and read all the instructions for how to use it. And a warning, if this is your first time learning about frameworks, these instructions can be very hard to understand. If you have any questions, you can email me supersimple.dev/feedback or leave a comment below. So now that we have a general sense of what a framework looks like, we're going to break down the three main parts of a framework. So the first part is rendering, which we just talked about. We write our code like this, and this is also known as templating. We're writing an HTML template where the values are filled by our data, and then the framework takes it, converts it into JavaScript, which then renders our web page. So the second feature of a framework is data handling. So all frameworks have a way for you to put your data in the framework, and then it will take the data and render it for you according to your web page. So it will take the values in your data and then fill your template with those values. And then when the data changes, for example, we add or remove a comment, the framework will automatically re-render for you so that your web page is always up to date with your data. So the third feature of a framework is called event handling, which means it helps you add event handlers to your page. So instead of writing button.onClick in JavaScript, the framework gives you an easy way to add event handlers to your HTML elements. This is also known as the MVC architecture, or Model View Controller. And this is what the majority of JavaScript frameworks are built on. And this is why if you have a good grasp of MVC, you shouldn't have much trouble learning a framework and switching from one framework to another. If you want to learn more about MVC, we build an MVC-based app in my JavaScript beginner tutorial, but I'll also make a specific video about MVC in the future, so please subscribe for that. Now, while you're at it, if you got value from this video, please click that like button below so this video reaches more people and helps people get tech careers. So these are the three main features of a framework. Some of them provide more features than this, but all frameworks have these three features. So the second part of this lesson is which framework should you learn if you want to get a job as a web developer? So in 2021, the front-end frameworks you should consider are React, Vue, or Angular, and avoid other front-end frameworks. So frameworks are created in generations. Just like an iPhone, you have the first generation, the second gen, etc. If you want to get a job, you need to learn the latest generation of JavaScript frameworks, because just like an iPhone, everyone wants to use the latest generation or they want to upgrade. So right now, React, Vue, and Angular are the latest generation of frameworks, and that's why you should pick one of these to learn. So the links to each of these frameworks are in the description. You can take a look at them and see which one interests you. So how long will it be before a new generation comes out and these frameworks become outdated? Well, the truth is that no one knows for sure, but I'll let you know as soon as it happens, so please be sure to subscribe. So of these three frameworks, which one should you learn? So the way this works is frameworks tend to be popular in certain regions. So pick the framework that is the most popular in the region you want to work in. For example, in the Bay Area and Toronto where I've worked, companies like to use React, so I've been using React. And it might be different for you. So what I do to figure this out is I go on LinkedIn or your country's job search website, and then I search for web developer jobs in the location that I want to work. And then I make a list of which frameworks come up most often, and I learn that one. And if there's two that come up equally as often, then you can try them out both and see which one you like better. So that's the end of this lesson. Thanks so much for watching the video. Today we learned what is a JavaScript framework and which one should you learn if you want to get a job as a web developer. So each framework has a step-by-step guide on how to set it up, and you can take a look at them in the description. If you have any trouble or if you have any questions, please send me an email at supersimple.dev/feedback. Thanks again for watching. My name is Simon from supersimple.dev, and I want to make a tech career possible for anyone. Stay positive, keep learning, and I'll see you in the next one.